What were the dinosaurs in the early Cretaceous period? The early Cretaceous period, which lasted from about 145 to 100 million years ago, was a time of great change and diversity on Earth. The land was lush with vegetation and the oceans teemed with life. The climate was warm and humid, with high levels of CO2 in the atmosphere, creating a tropical paradise. The Lower Cretaceous was also a time of significant volcanic activity, with large volcanic eruptions occurring all around the world, which might have affected the climate and the evolution of life. This led to a proliferation of lush tropical vegetation, including ferns, cycads, ginkgoes, and conifers. Angiosperms, or flowering plants, also began to appear during the early Cretaceous, but they were not yet dominant. The continents were still mostly joined together as the supercontinent Pangaea, and the oceans were shallower than they are today. As a result, there was a mixing of marine and terrestrial faunas, leading to the evolution of unique animals. Dinosaurs were the dominant land animals during the early Cretaceous, and new groups of dinosaurs such as the ornithopods and ceratopsians evolved during this time. Some of the most common dinosaurs of this period include hadrosaurs, also known as duck-billed dinosaurs, which were herbivores characterized by their wide, flat snouts and hundreds of cheek teeth that were used to grind up tough plant material. Iguanodonts, another group of herbivorous dinosaurs, were characterized by their thumb spikes and large, broad teeth. Some iguanodonts had bony crests on their heads, which may have been used for display or attracting mates. The land was dominated by giant sauropods such as Apatosaurus and Brachiosaurus, which roamed the lush forests, their long necks reaching high into the canopy to feed on leaves. They were the largest animals to ever walk the earth and protected by their size from most predators. They were hunted by large theropods, such as Deinonychus and Acrocanthosaurus, which roamed the land in search of their next meal. The oceans were also teeming with life, with marine reptiles such as ichthyosaurs and plesiosaurs swimming in the warm waters. These marine reptiles were adapted to different ways of life. Ichthyosaurs were fast swimmers, and plesiosaurs had long necks and small heads with four flippers. The skies were also filled with life, with early birds such as Archaeopteryx flying among the clouds. These early birds had feathers, but they were not yet capable of powered flight. They were closer to reptiles than to the birds we know today. In this ancient world, the days were filled with the sounds of dinosaurs bellowing and the rustling of leaves in the wind. The air was thick with the scent of blooming flowers. It's worth noting that the early Cretaceous is a vast period, and the dinosaurs that existed were commonly varied by location and region. Here are the characteristics of three dinosaurs from the early Cretaceous period that I find particularly interesting. Velociraptor. This small carnivorous theropod dinosaur was only about 6 feet long, but it was incredibly agile and fast. Velociraptors had a large, sickle-shaped claw on each foot, which it may have used to hunt and kill prey. It also had a large brain for its body size, which suggests that it was intelligent and had advanced sensory abilities. Ankylosaurus. This heavily armored herbivorous dinosaur was one of the last of the ankylosaurids, and it lived during the early Cretaceous. It was heavily armored with a bony club on the end of its tail, which could be used as a weapon. It also had bony plates called osteoderms covering its body, which would have protected it from predators. Spynosaurus. This theropod dinosaur is considered one of the largest carnivorous dinosaurs to ever live, even larger than T-Rex. It is estimated to have reached lengths of up to 59 feet and weigh as much as 20 tons. This dinosaur lived in what is now North Africa during the early Cretaceous. It was also semi-aquatic and had webbed feet, which suggests that it was an active hunter on both land and water. Its unique sail-like structure on its back, which may have been used to regulate its body temperature or for display, made it a very distinctive and intimidating predator. Marine reptiles such as ichthyosaurs and plesiosaurs were common in the oceans. Ichthyosaurs were marine reptiles that looked like dolphins and had streamlined bodies, dorsal fins, and a tail fluke. Plesiosaurs were marine reptiles that had a long neck, a small head, and four flippers. They were able to swim in a snake-like motion. In addition to the dinosaurs, many other fascinating animals lived during the early Cretaceous. For example, early mammals and birds also evolved during this time. Birds first appeared during the early Cretaceous and had feathers, but they were not yet capable of powered flight. Early mammals were small and nocturnal, and they lived in the shadows of the dinosaurs. The early Cretaceous period was home to some of the largest dinosaurs to ever exist. Here is a description of some of the largest dinosaurs of the early Cretaceous and their characteristics. Argentinosaurus. This sauropod dinosaur is considered one of the largest animals to ever walk the earth. It is estimated to have reached lengths of up to 115 feet and weighed as much as 100 tons. This dinosaur lived in what is now South America during the early Cretaceous. Its long neck and tail, as well as its large size, would have allowed it to reach tall trees and eat leaves from the top of the canopy. Its large size would have also protected it from most predators. The only one that could hunt it was the gigantosaurus. Gigantosaurus. This theropod dinosaur is considered one of the largest conifers dinosaurs to ever live, rivaling the size of the T-Rex. It is estimated to have reached lengths of up to 43 to 46 feet and weigh as much as 8 to 12 tons. This dinosaur lived in what is now South America during the early Cretaceous. It would have been a top predator hunting large herbivorous dinosaurs like the Argentinosaurus. Brachiosaurus. This sauropod dinosaur is considered one of the largest animals to ever walk the earth. It is estimated to have reached lengths of up to 27 meters and weigh as much as 90 tons. This dinosaur lived in what is now North America and Africa during the early Cretaceous. Its long neck and tail, as well as its large size, would have allowed it to reach tall trees and eat leaves from the top of the canopy. Its large size would have also protected it from most predators. Apatosaurus. This sauropod dinosaur is considered one of the largest animals to ever walk the earth. It is estimated to have reached lengths of up to 75 feet and weigh as much as 30 to 40 tons. This dinosaur lived in what is now North America. Its long neck and tail, as well as its large size, would have allowed it to reach tall trees and eat leaves from the top of the canopy. Its large size would have also protected it from most predators. It is worth noting that the size of these dinosaurs is still a matter of debate among paleontologists, and the size estimates may vary depending on the source and the method used for measurements. However, these dinosaurs were undoubtedly some of the largest animals to ever exist on Earth, and their size and characteristics made them unique and fascinating creatures of the early Cretaceous period. It's not accurate to think that all dinosaurs lived during the same period. Dinosaurs evolved during the Triassic period about 230 million years ago, and went extinct at the end of the Cretaceous period about 65 million years ago. The Cretaceous period is divided into two parts, the Lower Cretaceous and the Upper Cretaceous. The Lower Cretaceous lasted from about 145 to 100 million years ago, and the Upper Cretaceous lasted from about 100 to 65 million years ago. It is important to mention that not all dinosaurs lived in the same areas. They were distributed throughout the world during the Lower Cretaceous. The supercontinent Pangaea was still mostly together, which led to a mixing of marine and terrestrial faunas, while during the Upper Cretaceous, the continents were starting to separate, leading to a different distribution of species. The Spynosaurus and T-Rex, for example, were both large carnivorous dinosaurs, but they lived in different habitats and had different characteristics. Spynosaurus was semi-aquatic and had webbed feet, which suggests that it was an active hunter in both land and water. T-Rex, on the other hand, was a terrestrial predator that was adapted to hunting on land. It's worth noting that the idea of Spinosaurus and T-Rex fighting is often portrayed in popular cultures, such as movies, but it is not based on scientific evidence. It's pure speculation. In summary, dinosaurs lived during different periods of the Mesozoic era, and not all dinosaurs lived at the same time. The Lower and Upper Cretaceous were different periods with different dinosaurs, each with its own characteristics and adaptations. It's important to understand that the dinosaurs that are commonly known, like the T-Rex and Triceratops, lived during the Upper Cretaceous and not during the Lower Cretaceous.